Suddenly, referee Dennis Eitikin seemed to remember he had the technology. A substantial period of time had passed since substitute Federico Chiesa had tumbled under pressure from Ashley Young, Adam Lallana and James Tarkowski. It looked as if the crisis had passed. Then the official signaled for the dreaded VAR. He had a look. He pointed to the spot. England had reached 10 hours without conceding a goal, but Lorenzo Insigne ensured they would not make it to 11. Was it a penalty? Chiesa looked to have made the most of it. Equally, to have three players crowding around one in the area was a tad clumsy. England, Butland, Walker, Stones, Henderson 73, Tarkowski, Dyer, Trippier, Rose 60, Oxlade-Chamberlain, Lallana 60, Lingard, Cook 71, Young, Vardy, Rashford 70, Sterling subs not used, Hart, Pickford, Pope, Maguire, Mawson, Livermore, Alli, Welbeck booked, Oxlade-Chamberlain, Walker goals, Vardy 26 Italy, Donnarumma, Zappa Costa, Rugani, Bonucci, De Ciglio, Pellegrini, Gagliardini 79, Jorginho, Pirlo, Candreva, Chiesa 56, Immobile, Belotti 64, Insigne subs not used, Buffon, Perrin, Ferrari, Darmian, Ogbonna, Bonaventura, Verratti, Spinazzola, Verdi, Cotroni, Cristante, Florenzi referee, Dennis Eitikin, Germany, England will need to be better than that in Russia, so, too, perhaps will VAR. That aside, it was another decent night for Gareth Southgate and his team. More progress and promise. England may have won had the teams remained stable. As usual, the invasion of substitutes kills the flow. It was a good night, too, for Jamie Vardy, who picks his victims well. Spain, Germany, Holland and now Italy for England, and every team in the Premier League's top six this season. Okay, the internationals were all friendlies. Even so, these are still elite players with elite nations, and Vardy finds a way through. It is not as easy as he makes it look. When the clock ticked past the 64th minute at Wembley yesterday, England passed the 10-hour mark without conceding a goal. That shows how hard it is. The results was not the worst, either. The outcomes of international friendlies are often dismissed as unimportant, but confidence isn't. England have now, in the space of 5 days, defeated Holland away and played well for long periods against Italy at home. And while neither nation is a force right now, and neither will be in Russia this summer, there is still a pleasant satisfaction in that. Holland subsequently went to European champions Portugal and won 3-0, and while Italy lost to a Lionel Messi-less Argentina last week, they had enough about them yesterday to suggest they will be back. So these are still happy days for the manager. Southgate is encouraging England's back three to play. The forwards are quick and lively of thought, and in the combination of Kieran Trippier at right wing-back with Kyle Walker at right centre-half, England's manager has found an innovative and imaginative option. The same can be said of Ashley Young, deployed at left then right-back, and of the smartness of Jesse Lingard and Raheem Sterling's performances. This is a plan that, while not without flaws, is gradually coming together. There were a couple of negatives last night. The early mistakes by John Stones, the yellow cards issued to Alex Oxlade-Chamberlain and Young in what was, at times, quite spiky for a friendly. Tempers will need to be kept in check under the pressure of tournament football, and more care in the penalty area, too. Game intelligence. How often has its absence from England performances been bemoaned in recent years? Outwitted by Germany in 2010, outwitted by Uruguay in 2014, frozen by Iceland's sheer spirit in 2016. All the more reason, then, to acknowledge the goal that gave England the lead last night. It was smart. It was quick thinking. It was all the things English footballers are not supposed to be. And it was the football brain of Jesse Lingard that was responsible, so often happy to be depicted as the class clown, and playing up to it with his social media profile. This has been a coming-of-age season for him, despite the antics. Yet nobody breaks into the Manchester United first team at a time of such immense investment without having a high IQ on the football field. And Lingard was thinking more brightly than just about anyone else in his orbit when putting Jamie Vardy away for England's opener. Credit Raheem Sterling, too, for his sheer persistence. Moments earlier he had burst through the centre, been brought down, but got to his feet sharply, able to continue the run. He slipped Vardy in, but his finish was ordinary and was saved with little fuss by goalkeeper Gianluigi Donnarumma. Soon after, the same again. Sterling on the run, Sterling sent tumbling, Sterling up and carries on. Sterling felled again. Rightly, he was furious. While he was using the stoppage to implore referee Dennis Eitikin of Germany to take a firmer line with Italy's defensive line, Lingard was using it to put the ball down and take football's equivalent of a scrum half's tap and go. He passed the ball swiftly into Vardy, who made no mistake with his second opportunity of the night. This time Donnarumma had no chance. The ball lashed in with Vardy's right foot, his first goal for England in 366 days. Once again, there was much to like about England going forward. The speed, the movement, yes, the intelligence. When a set piece broke down and Ashley Young chased Italy's counter-attack out to the flank, it placed him on the same side of the pitch as right wing back Kieran Trippier, who filled in for Young on the left. Lingard, doing his duty until Young could cross the pitch. At other time, England stretched Italy on the flanks, largely through excellent running by Alex Oxlade-Chamberlain and Sterling in the middle, Young and Trippier wide. Sterling, in particular, caused problems, and came close to setting up Young shortly before halftime, his shot deflected just wide of the far post. At other times, Trippier tested Italy with a succession of well-struck corners. Sooner or later, this is going to pay off, maybe in Russia this summer against opponents not so seasoned at defending dead balls. Yet this is not to say England's display was flawless. Far from it. They could have been three goals down before the Vardy strike, and on each occasion questions had to be asked of the defense. From Italy's first attack, Jorge Luis Jorginho floated a neat pass read by Ciro Immobile, but not John Stones, who allowed the striker to run off him into space. Dawdling on the ball, he was caught. But a more clinical striker would not have been, or even a Panamanian with his dander up. Perhaps rattled by this early lapse, Stones then allowed Immobile to catch him in possession on the edge of his own penalty area, the ball seemingly lost beneath his feet. That should have been a goal, too. That England could have been two down in 3 minutes, and at fault both times, is sloppiness Gareth Southgate can ill afford in Russia. Then, in the 17th minute, a wonderful chance of Italy's own creation. Antonio Candreva hit a quick outstanding cross from the right, met by Immobile again in the middle. He should have scored, and there have been plenty of Italian strikers who would from that position, but Immobile sent his header flying over the bar. He's far from static, as his name suggests, but he's not the best at hitting the target. More inaccurate than Immobile. He had another run and a shot that went wide, and Marco Parolo hit a fierce shot from 25 yards that came close, but the initial wastefulness might explain why Italy will not be at the World Cup this summer. England won't be there long, either, unless they look sharp from the start.